إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ثم أما بعد، توقفنا في لقاء سبق في أول سورة البقرة مع آيات تتناول أو تتحدث عن الله سبحانه وتعالى وأخرى تتحدث عن الإنسان. We went before about some verses of the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Quran telling us about himself, and some ayat, some verses which talk about insan, you and me. And last time we talked about the rizq, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is providing us and our rule, our goal is to spend as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and from whatever we provided them, they spend. And when you continue the ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at the end of talking about the believers, Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Those will be on guidance from their Rabb, from their Master, from their Creator, and those will be the successful one. And we notice, يعني نلاحظ أن كلمة ربهم جمعت بين الرب سبحانه وتعالى وبين الإنسان through the pronoun, الضمير. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying رب and him talking about us. Allah is our رب. And in this beautiful ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also talk about huda, guidance from him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is a رب that created everything and the insan merely, and then he gave him hidayah. He gave him guidance, and if you follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be with the successful one. It's a different equation from what people talking about, how to be successful in your life. The seven habits, as the most successful people, everything they measure with money or positions or whatever, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has different hisab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has different criteria for how to be really successful. So we start with the word Rabb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the word Rabb, as we said before, we use it in Surah Al-Fatiha, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All the time, we repeat this dua many times, and Yawm Al-Qiyamah, at the end, when the people of Jannah will go to Jannah, and people of Hellfire will go to Al-Nar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran said, وَقِيلَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. It will be said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. So the name Rabb, and when it's connected to Al-Alameen, the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has a lot of specific meaning and importance to the belief, to the aqeedah of Muslims. Rabb comes from the root word Rababa. أصلها رببة من الزيادة. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, He gave us this beautiful name from الزيادة. And it gives you the meaning of al-khalq, wal-ri'ayah, wal-inayah, the creation, the taking care of, give importance to something. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabb, ata'uhu fi izdiyad, khalquhu fi izdiyad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His creation, every day something increase. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His mercy to us increase. His creation is increasing. His taking care of us is increasing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word Rababa, we use it in our language in a way we say Rabwa for a small hill, because هذا يعني شيء زاد زاد عن الأرض, something above the level of the earth, so we call it uphill or Rabwa. Riba, when you lend money or borrow money, would increase because there is a sense of increasing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this meaning of Rabwa, it's something increase. We use it for the word tarbiyah, how to raise our children, subhanAllah. Because when you raising your child, عندما تربي ابنك, what's happening? Every day you are mainly increasing something in him, not only the muscles, not only the body, not only the bones, but the moral values, his ideology, he's thinking about the universe, what he believes in all the time. So the tarbiyah, subhanAllah, comes also from the same, coming from the same meaning. وَالتَّرْبِيَةُ هُوَ إِنْشَاءُ الشَّيْءِ حَالًا فَحَالًا إِلَى حَدِّ التَّمَامِ SubhanAllah. Is to increase something, to add something to it more and more until to come to a perfect state. In our human level, this is where the word الرب comes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He gives us something so and so. And we can go through the Quran, as I said, there is all the time we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. We have many ayat speaks about الرب. Fir'aun claimed, they said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى, I am your great Rabb. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قَوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. And we see the word Fir'aun has a specific meaning in the Quran. Actually, the word Fir'aun is not a name of the ruler. Fir'aun, Baytul Hakim, the palace or the house of the ruler. Something similar to Al-Baytul Abyad, the White House, where the president stayed. So, Fir'aun, subhanAllah, became a symbol. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy in the Quran, is not talking about names, it's not talking about individuals. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching us about Fir'aun, about a state, about a symbol, that if you do, if you behave like him, you will become like Fir'aun. So Fir'aun, when Musa debated with him, Fir'aun asked Musa, قَالَ فَمَنْ رَبُّكُمَا يَا مُوسَى, who's your Rabb? فَقَالَ مُوسَى عَلَيْهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, قال ربنا الذي أعطى كل شيء خلقه ثم هدى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Rabb, is the one who gave each thing its form and then guided it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything and gave subhanallah to all His creation what is good for it, what suits it. The best of what you have is the best that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only that, Allah is still managing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still taking care of this. So this is the initial creation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then the continuous taking care and management from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to His creation. And if you can take it in a moral dimension or in our bodies, there is, subhanAllah, there is a simple thing in our body, subhanAllah, just to show you how great our Rabb is. You know, subhanAllah, our bodies, we have different cells, and every cell is responsible for something. So there is some cells for bones, and we know at certain age, our bones, our skeleton will stop growing. Okay? So these, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send a command to these cells to stop, and they will go in a sleep mode. After 50 years, 60 years, no, you don't need it through your life. Maybe you are 70 years old and all of a sudden you break your arm. Then now we have two pieces. And then we want these bones to come together. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Rabb, will wake up these cells that are responsible for bones and start to produce bones, to weld the two pieces together. SubhanAllah. And this is a great meaning of a Rabb. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking care of us. And this is why many people, when they are confused, when they don't know what to do, when they question Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you. And He gave you the best to for you to function and to work properly. And subhanAllah, this will lead us for the meaning of al-huda. And if we talk about the Rabb, it will take years to talk just about our Rabb and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing for us. But there's more than 1,000 times in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the word the Rabb. Go and study and read and see for each position and each ayah how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk to us about our Rabb. And because He's our Rabb, He's our Creator, He gave us Huda. And this is the link between our Rabb and Hidayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a creator. And because He's a creator, He gave us what is good for us. So when you take the hidayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you take it from the main source. And you take what is good for you. And subhanAllah, we do this in our life. We all buy equipment and tools and machines and, you know. And the first thing we do is we open the instruction manual. Because the manufacturer will send this piece of paper with his tool or equipment and ask us to follow the instructions manual. By following the instruction manuals, by following the recommendation of the manufacturer, will maintain this equipment to the end of its life. And wallahi al-mathal al-a'la, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the highest example. It is, wallahi, sometimes I feel I'm repeating myself, but our deen is simple. Ad-deen basir, wasahl. But because we forget the basics, we are deviating from the as-sirat al-mustaqim, from the straight path. Because we're looking for big names. But deen is simple, Quran is simple. This Bedouin in the desert, when they listen to the Quran, when they listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they change with simple facts. Sometimes we study aqidah with big terms and big names. And Allah used simple way to talk to simple people. So take it easy. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the hidayah. And ulama said that the hidayah is two types. Hidayatul irshad wa hidayatul tawfiq. This hidayah, I will call it the general hidayah and the specific hidayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us, all of us, Muslims and non-Muslims. Being insane, being a human, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assure you that you will get the guidance from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And things that Allah knows that you need it, Allah will leave it in your hand. You breathe. Can you control your breathing? Can you say, I will stop. I will change the oxygen to something else. You can't. The water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make it essential for us. This is part of the hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The things that are very necessary to us, that we cannot live with them, out of His hidayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it a nature to us. That we do it without even controlling ourselves. Why? Because it is a necessity. It is something that we cannot live without it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for our decision-making process, give us two hidayah. Number one, the general hidayah, that is guaranteed for everyone. And the second one is hidayah to tawfiq. Allah will make it easy for you. Allah will give you extra to accept Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and to know Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you take a simple example, an analogy, we all have GPS now. And remember before, maybe 15 years ago, or maybe more than 10 years, we have maps. You go and buy a map, and you keep it with you in your car all the time, and you need someone beside you to be your navigator, and you plan your trip. And you have to go through this street and turn right in a certain way, and so on. Now we have GPS. Everybody will tell you, I'll explain to you how to come to my house. He will tell you, no, just give me the address. Text me your address. This is ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You take the address. You punch it in your smartphone or your GPS. Now you have steps to follow. You know what to do. And by following the steps, so the steps is available for everyone. Following the steps is extra that you have to make. And the more you follow the steps, the more assurance you will reach your destination. And even sometimes people, because they trust their GPS so much, they don't even think, even if they know the area, they say, I will follow it. And subhanAllah, some people question the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will say something and people, you know, start to think about it. We trust some hardware and software, and when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people raise some questions. Afillahi shak. There's a doubt about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we follow the steps from this lady, turn right, 500 meter turn left, and we do it, subhanAllah. When you do it, what will happen? You reach your destination. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Allah has the highest example. We do the same. We do the same. You follow the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so simple. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us guidance in the Quran. Many things to do. And some people said, I don't know how to read and write. I don't understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, sent the prophets and messengers. Arsala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-anbiya wa rusul. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أولئك الذين هدى الله فبهداه مقتدر. Those are the one that Allah سبحانه وتعالى guided. يا محمد follow them. And then he told us لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. You have a good example in رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم to follow. So people start to follow the prophets and messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have a problem, you love women so much, or women chasing you, huh? Follow Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. Study Prophet Yusuf. Make Yusuf your model. If you don't have children and you feel bad, whatever, follow Zakariya sallallahu alayhi wasalam. If you have sickness and you don't know what to do, follow Ayyub sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And so on. Allah give us all the prophets, all the anbiya and rusul for us to follow. It's so simple, but we don't want to do it. And then he sent us the best of the best sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told us, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. You have the best example in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is our top model. As human, this is our top model. In every aspect of life, Rasulullah sallam will give you something. In business, in deen, in marriage, in divorce, in ruling a country, in conflicts, Rasulullah sallam was a school. You know, as Sheikh Kishki used to say, rahmatullahi, huna madrasatu al-habibi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. School of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what you need to learn. And this is what you need to follow. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his mercy, give us a beautiful example of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ثم أما بعد. I'm sorry, there is nothing new I have to say, because I'm sure you all know this. And our deen, since 1400 years, doesn't change. What it changes is how we deliver the deen. But the deen itself are the same. The Qur'an, for 1400 years, how many millions of us memorize the Qur'an? And we are repeating over and over. We repeat Surah Al-Fatiha. How many times? After Salah, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, 33 times. People say, you know, because they don't think. We are blindly follow the West. And I have no problem following the West in technology, but not in the social sciences, on the what makes people change. The human behavior has to come from our deen. And let me end by giving you two examples of Rasulullah sallam, of the hidayah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Simple things that we forget. Rasulullah sallam said, عن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه لا يخلون رجل بامرأة إلا وكان الشيطان ثالثهما أو فإن الشيطان ثالثهما. رسول الله said that when a man and a woman sit alone, شيطان will be number three. سبحان الله. On the few months, last few months, how many stories we heard about politicians, well-known people, you know, was accused of sexual harassment and, you know, issues like this from different women. And subhanAllah, simple hidayah from Rasulullah sallallahu that when you have a woman, don't be alone with a woman. In an office, in your car, in a house, with relatives, simple hidayah. But we keep forgetting to follow the huda of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Many problems will be eliminated. You see, we keep solving the result of the problem, but we don't go to the main cause. And this is the beauty about Islam. Islam will go to the root cause of the problem and solve it from the beginning. And how many of us forget this? You know, how many of us will go to MSA meeting, you know, Muslim Student Association, in every school or every university? We have a lot of Muslim students. They love Islam. They are sincere. I have no doubt in it. And then you find a brother and sister sitting alone, planning for an Islamic event, and they're sitting alone. you know, والغايات لا تبرر الوسائل. The means have to have the same rule of the goals. We cannot serve Islam by disobeying Islam. So simple huda from Muhammad sallam will solve many problems. The other hidayah that we have, عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال التأني من الله والعجلة من الشيطان. That this hadith, some ulama said Hassan, it's good, and some ulama said ضعيف. So it's and وحسنه الألباني. Sheikh Albani said this hadith is Hassan. Anyhow, so تأني, patience, slow down, not rushing, but don't be lazy, is from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. العجلة, to rush, run all the time, from الشيطان. And I take this hadith in two dimensions. In business, you know, or even in social life, when people send an email or text you something, and they expect you, because you can read the email right away, or you receive a text message right away, they expect you to do what? To reply. And imagine the rushing and the pressure that we all have, because we have all this flood of emails and messages that we cannot handle. And subhanAllah, we feel the pressure, we feel the stress. And I used to tell my friends, you know what, when you send me a message, it takes 3 days. I'm old man. I use a normal way. The mail will take, the normal old mail will take 2 to 3 days. So when you send me a text, don't expect me to reply right away. I will take my time. I need to take my time. Imagine all these emails in business, and everybody wanted urgent. It's rushing, you know, you have to do it now. And then what we have? We have a flood of now, urgent, that we cannot do. So people has to realize that there is a time. Time factor is important. Time is important factor in our life. Things has to take its time. SubhanAllah, sometimes you have an idea, and if you don't give it time to think about it, you know, they sleep on it, okay, you make the wrong decision. And many people calling, seeking an advice, and he need the answer now. And because you don't have the time to process the idea, you say an opinion, and then it was wrong. After 2-3 days, you think about it again, you say, no, this is wrong, and you call him student. The second dimension of this hadith that you all heard about, the accident that happened a few weeks ago. Some young people were racing on Eglinton and Mavis, and the lady, may Allah give her rahmah, passed away. And subhanAllah, when you think about it, it was mainly because of what? Racing. Young people are racing. And Rasulullah said, Al-ajalatu min ash-shaytan. Racing from shaytan. I understand there's some emergencies that we have to run. We have a fire, and the fire truck has to run. We understand. This is why we open in the West. Like back home, they block. SubhanAllah. So what we do is we open room for the fire truck to run quickly. So there's some incidents we need emergency, we need to run. But in normal condition, why people are racing? And Rasulullah out of his hidayah, Rasulullah said, إِذَا أُقِيمَتِ الصَّلَاةِ, when the salah started, فَلَا تَأْتُوهَا وَأَنْتُمْ تَسْعَوُونَ. Don't come to the salah and you are running or rushing or jogging. وَأْتُوهَا وَأَنْتُمْ إِهْ تَمْشُونَ. Come walking. فَمَا أَدْرَبْتُمْ فَصَلُّوا وَمَا فَاتَكُمْ فَأَتِمُّوا. Whatever you reach, pray. And if you, after the Imam says Salaam Alaikum, you complete your salah. Simple hidayah from Rasulullah. Thousands of hidayah that we forget. And if we learn one hidayah every day, every week, and we implement, how our life will change. And this is the problem. People all the time, again, looks for big names, a great speech, but facts are simple. Math is simple. All we have to do is go back to the Quran and see what Rasulullah sallam will do in this scenario. You know, I remember one a Christian friend, he was from Lebanon, so he speaks Arabic, and he have hard time in his life, and he want to open like a nightclub, so he can make good money. And he's not Muslim, and he's asking me, is it halal or haram? And I don't know what to tell him. Yani for him, everything is halal, you know. So I ask him simple, I reply to him with a simple answer. I said, imagine if Isa alayhi salam, you believe in him. And I don't discuss how he believes in him. But Isa is walking in front of your nightclub. And you say, assalamu alaikum, please come in. Can you invite him in? He said, no, I can't. I said, why? He said, because it's haram. He knows from his heart that this is haram. This is not right. He cannot bring Isa in. We cannot bring Muhammad in, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this simple criteria that we, the hidayah that we need to know, will improve our life. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us believe in him as a Rabb. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to his hidayah. Nas Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an nu'mina bihi rabban lil alamin بحق الربوبية ونسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يهدينا إليه سواء السبيل اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم يا رب العالمين نسألك في هذا اليوم العظيم وفي هذا المقام العظيم أن تغفر ذنوبنا وأن تكفر عنا سيئاتنا وأن تتوفنا مع الأبرار اللهم ردنا والمسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل زمان وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى الأسير وحرر ديار المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل زمان وفي كل مكان اللهم نسألك يا رب العالمين أن ترحم آباءنا وأمهاتنا إلى يوم الدين اللهم يا رب العالمين اهد ذرياتنا اللهم ردهم إلى الإسلام ردا جميلا اللهم نسألك قلوبا تقية من الشرك نقية لا جافية ولا شقية ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم ارحمني وارحمكم الله.